Hi DIYers, Sterling here from Alarm Grid, and today we're going to show you how to install a 5809 wireless heat detector. We have another video that shows you how to program your 5809 into a wireless Lynx Touch alarm system, but now we're just going to show you how to physically mount it. 5809 is a great sensor to use in the kitchen because instead of the 5808W3, which is a smoke and heat detector, this is a standalone heat detector only. Therefore, in rooms like the kitchen, where you may have smoke when there is not a real fire, you're not gonna get false alarms. So if you're cooking, you burn something, or you just open your oven and you get a lot of smoke, if you had a smoke and heat in the kitchen, you would have a lot of problems with false alarms. We always recommend for the kitchen, you put a 5809. Some other good locations are for commercial spaces and shops where you may have dust, things like that. Again, another good option is to use a 5809 instead of the 5808W3. So, that was my tamper. Sorry about that. And another important note with the 5809 is that it's got two modes of detection. So it will alert and sound an alarm if the temperature in the room goes over a fixed temperature of 135 degrees Fahrenheit. This metal disc would pop out, your alarm would go off, and your heat detector has protected you for the fire. Now, if the fixed temperature sensor is set off and this metal disc pops out, you will need to replace the device. So it is a one-time use only sensor in the sense of the fixed heat detector. However, at the same time, this will protect if there is a rapid change in heat. So if the ambient temperature in the room jumps 15 degrees in less than 1 minute, a heat detector or this heat detector would also trigger an alarm. So when it's a rapid rise heat sensor or heat alarm, it will not pop the head and you would not have to replace the device. So that's an important distinction. In relation to that, you do not want to install this in any room where the ambient temperature would be over 100 degrees Fahrenheit, because then the rapid rise would not work. So now that we've described how the 5809 works, we're going to show you how to install it. You've got the head and the base, two-piece device. You turn it counterclockwise, which trips our tamper again because we've already programmed this. And we have a simple plastic base plate. This base plate allows you to install on a ceiling, wall, gang box, all kinds of places. So you've got four holes for mounting it. You also have a hole here for an anti-twist, so that once you have it physically mounted, if you go to pop the head off, the entire base wouldn't come off and come down. So you could use that as well. We're not going to install it that way for us, but I just wanted to point it out. So we have already drilled our two holes. We set this up. We stenciled in two holes for our two spots. We used our power drill our holes, and we have our plastic wall anchors in there. And we then use the two screws that come with the 5809. We have a Phillips head screwdriver, and we're going to simply line this up. I'm tall enough that I don't need a ladder, but if you were going to mount it on the ceiling, you would obviously want to use a stepladder, and we're just going to simply screw this in. Don't tighten it all the way till we're done. So that's screw hole number one, and then number two. You want to use at least two of the mounting holes. There are four. You can do all four if you would like. We're going to just stick with the two. Again, don't screw all the way down, because on the bigger side of the hole is where you want to start so that you can slide it into place. And then you simply turn it clockwise. Kind of locks into place, and then to make sure it won't come down, we want to tighten it down at this point. Nice and tight, it's not going anywhere. Base plate is installed. We have our 5809. We have already inserted our battery. We have already learned it into our Lynx Touch panel. We have a video showing you how to do that, so check it out. Make sure not to touch the metal disc as you install. You'll notice there are two tabs on opposite sides. They match up with the two holes here. So we want to line that up. And then simply twist into place, which has tripped our tamper again. And now we have our 5809 wireless heat detector installed and ready to detect a true fire in our kitchen. If you have any questions on how to install a 5809, please leave it in the comment section below and make sure to subscribe to our channel for all future videos.